Ivan's presentation is entitled High Throughput Phenotyping for Indirect Selection for Leaf Spot and Groundnut Rosette Disease Resistance in Peanut Breeding Programs in Uganda. And Ivan, I'll let you take it from here.
Yes, good morning, everyone. I'm Chapu Ivan, master student at Makerere University in Uganda. I'll be presenting on high throughput phenotyping for indirect selection for late leaf spot and groundnut rosette resistance in peanut breeding in Uganda. Groundnut rosette disease and late leaf spot are the most important foliar diseases in Uganda, causing up to 100% yield losses. Late leaf spot causes up to 60%, but when these diseases occur in combination, they cause up to 100% yield losses. Land breeding efforts have been geared towards development of resistant and high-yielding varieties. Selection for LLS and GRD resistance in breeding usually involves visual skills, like in the breeding program where I did my research, we used a 1-9 LLS scale by Subramaniam, 1995, and the 1-5 GRD severity scale by Naidu, 1998. Visual skills are dependent on human expertise. When breeding populations are large, like it is in very many breeding programs, then the number of experimental plots are many, and therefore there is need to phenotype these populations faster, and therefore more people are usually hired to do this, are required to do this phenotyping. That increases the costs of breeding, and because we are dealing with people, there is lots of human error and high variation now among the people collecting the data because everyone comes with their own human error. And because of this, the quality of phenotypic data is usually compromised and selection for resistance becomes difficult. We all know that high quality phenotypic data is needed for accurate selection in breeding. And therefore, there is need to improve the phenotyping methods used in groundnut breeding. High throughput phenotyping has been suggested as one of the ways to improve the phenotyping process. High throughput phenotyping is faster, accurate, and we get objective measurements. High throughput phenotyping simply means use of sensors to extract information from the plants. These high throughput phenotyping tools have been successfully used in breeding programs of cereals, mainly wheat, maize, and sorghum. However, due to the differences between cereals and peanut, we cannot directly transfer what has been successfully applied in cereals to groundnuts. Therefore, there is need to test these tools for effective deployment in groundnut breeding for routine selection for traits of interest like LLS and GRD resistance and variety performance. This brings me to my objectives. The general objective is to contribute to the development and deployment of high throughput phenotyping tools for selection in groundnut breeding, specifically to analyze the association between visual breeder scores and HTP estimated traits using Pearson correlation. And I hypothesize that visually assessed plant traits are related with HTP estimated traits. Justification. This study is critical for optimizing the application of HTP tools for routine selection in groundnut breeding. Effectively, deployment of HTP for GRD and LLS resistance selection will reduce the cost and time of groundnut variety development. In the long run, use of HTP tools is cheaper and resources can be concentrated on promising lines at harvest. Materials and methods. 50 genotypes were used in this study, genotypes from the nursery and research breeding programs. These genotypes were planted out at two locations, Nasari and Nakabango Jinja, which are LLS and GRD hotspots in Uganda. The data was collected across four data points, 5 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks, and 16 weeks, which was at harvest. So for agronomic traits, I collected data on disease severity. On LLS severity, I used the 1-9 scale, GRD percentage disease incidence, GRD rosette severity, which was on a 1-5 scale. Then HTP traits, I collected canopy temperature. I used a flare infrared camera. Normalized difference vegetation index, I used a green seeker. Then I collected a total of 11 RGB indices from the RGB camera. The image software was used for extraction of these indices. We had the green area, greener area, the hue, intensity, A, V, saturation, and coxinescence index. So adjusted means we obtained from analysis of variance, from analysis of variance for both visual and HTP scores, then a Pearson correlation between the HTP scores and the visually scored traits was carried out, and simple linear models were developed using the LM function of R. Results and discussion. From the Pearson correlation between the LLS and HTP parameters, we see that NDVI was the best correlated parameter to the visually scored disease symptoms. It was negatively correlated, and NDVI is associated with healthy canopies. So with increasing severity, there is less vigor in the plant canopy. So increasing disease severity of the LLS causes defoliation. And since NDVI is associated with reflectance from the canopy, you have less leaves in the plant canopy, and therefore there is less NDVI. And so resistant genotypes tend to have higher NDVI values compared to the susceptible ones with lower values. And therefore, plant breeders can actually select for genotypes with higher NDVI, and by so doing, they are indirectly selecting for resistance. Then looking at also canopy temperature was moderately correlated with LLS symptoms. So increasing disease severity increased the canopy temperature. This is because with the defoliation, you have less leaves. And we all know leaves are responsible for cooling of the canopy. They cool the canopy through transpiration. So when the disease increases, the leaves fall off and the plant is not able to cool itself. And therefore, you have warmer canopies. So breeders can actually target plants with warmer canopies, thereby selecting for resistance. So you can actually select for resistance indirectly just by selecting for some of these traits. Then for GRD, so still NDVI was the best related parameter to GRD symptoms. NDVI is associated with the presence of biomass and the vigor of the canopy. So when you look at our two plants, A and B, those are plants suffering from the green rosette and the yellow rosette. Those plants are way too smaller compared to the normal plants. So because they are small, there is reduced biomass. And since NDVI is associated with the presence of a healthy canopy, more biomass, we always have more heat plants having less NDVI values. Then it's also worth to note that the green area and greener area are associated with a negative associated with GRD severity, because once the plant is heat, the area it occupies is greatly reduced, and thereby reducing the green area. So breeders can actually select for higher greener area since it's associated with higher biomass. So plants which are bigger are not hit, and the ones which are smaller have been severely hit. So you can indirectly select for resistance of GRD using green area. So how can these parameters be directly incorporated into the breeding process? We develop regression models. So here, since all these measurements are taken based on the visual visual skills, we have to relate them back to the visual skills. So in our first case, we have LLS related with the NDVI, and we have our model. Our model is explaining about 74% of the variation in our population. And so once we have this linear model, we can actually work backwards and predict the severity score of the plot. So if we have our NDVI score, we can fit it in our model and we get the estimated severity score. Since we have our severity score 1 to 3 being resistant, 4 to 5 being moderately resistant, and 8 to 9 being highly susceptible. So if we fit and we get any of the values, we can actually determine if the plant is resistant or not. The same applies for GRB severity. We can do the same, and by so doing, we can indirectly select for resistance. So these methods will help us to complement the already existing traditional methods, which are the visual skills. So we are not creating new methods, but we are supplementing on what the breeders are already using to aid the selection. Conclusion, HTP estimated traits are highly correlated with visual breeder scores. NDVI in particular is suitable for early selection for LLS and GRE resistance. By early selection, we can select for resistance as early as 12 weeks, which is a month away from our harvest time. So by so doing, we are able to save time and labor. And because there is consistency in our data, there is reputability, anyone can collect this data using these tools. So you don't have to have one person collecting the data, and a lot of time is actually saved. So what is the way forward from here? We can explore multiple regression models for better accuracy. Since, as I'd shown earlier, I was using simple linear models, which involve just use of one parameter. But I believe by adding more parameters to our equations, we can be able to accurately estimate the resistance within our plants. So, and then thereafter, these models need to be validated for consistency in selection. So we need to validate these models in a different population or in a different location to see how they perform. And if the models are performing quite well and with a high level of consistency, we recommend them for use of selection within the breeding program. And then the heritability of the HTP indices should be calculated. We should only consider traits which have high heritability, because these are the ones whose values are genetically controlled. We don't want something with a lower heritability, because if it has a lower heritability, it's probably controlled by environmental factors. So we need something which is more stable. So I would like to thank the Peanut Innovation Lab for funding this study, Makerere University, and Naro Nasari for hosting my research, and most importantly to my academic advisors, Dr. Okello Omom, Dr. Okello Kalule, and Dr. Maria Balota. Thank you for listening. We now take any questions, if there are any.
Thank you, Yvonne. We have time for a couple questions. And the first question is one that I had as well. Question comes from Dr. Albert Colbreth. It says, Yvonne, are there other diseases or conditions that might occur that confound relationships between NDVI and late leaf spot or GRD?
Excuse me, I didn't get that quite well.
Okay, this question comes from Dr. Albert Colbreth. And he says, are there other diseases or conditions such as drought that might occur that confound relationship between NDVI and late leaf spot or GRD?
Okay, so the question is, are there any other confounding factors that could affect the LLS, the NDVI values? Yes, there could be, but during the time of my study, I did not have any drought and I only had LLS and GRD in the field, but I do believe drought could affect as well. But in my case, I did not have the drought. I only had LLS and GRD as the stress factors in the field.
Okay, thank you very much. And that's the time we have for this presentation. So thank you very much, Yvonne.